Welcome to the Hour of Harvest. It is great to have you with us as we worship the Lord. Sit back and enjoy as we share the good news of the gospel. We invite you to participate along with us as we sing songs of praise, read the Bible, and pray for those in need. The Hour of Harvest prayer team is standing by to take your prayer requests, praise reports, and lead souls to the Lord. You may call us at 606-464-4250 at any time during this program. May this program be a place where you feel accepted, loved, forgiven, and encouraged in the Lord. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls with the unconditional love of Christ from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. From our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your special guest host.
Welcome to another night of Hour of Harvest worship tonight. We are we're blessed to be here tonight to be with you and to have a wonderful singing group come to us tonight. And I'm filling in tonight, me and my partner here, Sam Reed. We're filling in for Sister Margaret tonight. She has taken a few days off to be with Don. So you keep her in prayer as we go through this night and through the rest of this week before the new year starts. But it's been really good to be with you right now. I'm going to read you a scripture tonight, and we'll talk a little bit about having some peace in all of our circumstances that we're in. Paul writes in the book of Philippians in chapter 4 and verse 19, he says, "And my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus." And you know, if we look through several scriptures here, we see that God tells us over in Matthew and chapter 6 and verse 31 and 32, he tells us, "Therefore do not worry, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? He says, for after all these things the Gentiles seek, for your heavenly Father knows you need all these things." You see, we have the promise from God. The promise is that he said that he would supply all of our needs. And you know, this time of year, as we go through life, we see a lot of heartache. And it seems like it's reminded to us more and more each and every day during this time of Christmas, our Lord and Savior's birth. We get with family and friends and we celebrate. But it seems like we're always in a hurry. We're always trying to hustle about and do the things that just gets us all out of whack and out of sorts. And, you know, I can tell you, God of peace is with us. And he told us in 1 Timothy and chapter 6 and verse 6, he says, "Now godliness with contentment is great gain." Godliness with contentment. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm going to send out a request for you tonight. Is try your hardest for the next few days before this new year comes in to be content. Yes. To be content with what God is supplying you. Because he is supplying all of our needs. He said that he even feeds the birds in the air. He feeds all the animals that are out there. So why should we worry about what God is going to do for us? You know, we need to put our faith and trust in God. We need to stand on that promise to know that he is there with us. You see, he loved us so much that he sent Jesus, his son, to be with us. And he died for us so that we could have the promise of everlasting life. You know, we've got folks up top there. They're standing by at the phones. They're waiting for your phone calls to come in. And I know you have many prayer requests that needs to come in. If you have a need to be saved tonight, if you listen to these songs that are being sung, and you feel the Holy Spirit moving in you tonight, give them a call. They will pray with you. They will pray with you through to victory. You will have that salvation that God intended for all of us to have. But we have to seek Jesus when we do that. You know, we just have so much to be thankful for this time of year. But, you know, it gives me a great pleasure tonight to introduce to you a group that's come from Wellington, Kentucky. It is the Kentucky Wayfaring Strangers. They are a good singing group. I've already heard them singing. It's a wonderful, wonderful music that you hear. And they have a contact person. That's Pastor Jay Keaton. His phone number is 606-768-9959. And they're with the Liberty and Faith podcast. So we'll take and at this time, we'll turn you over to the singers and we'll get started with some good music.
Well, we are thankful to be with you, and we didn't really come to entertain, but we come to worship. And I'm Pastor Jay, and this is Gail and Bill Reichert. And I like that word that the brother just brought. We can be distracted by so many things. And we, as we're singing these songs, we want to lift up Jesus to you. And listen, you know, you can't let circumstances in this life dictate your faith. And so this song Bill wrote says, "Let's praise him." We can praise him no matter what's going on in this life. You just need to reach out from the little box that Satan's trying to put you in and reach your hand up to Jesus Christ, and God will bless you. I surely will. Join us in prayer as we begin the night. Father in heaven, we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh, we lift your holy name. There is no other name given among men by which we must be saved, and we're so thankful for the name. Lord, we're not only thankful for that name, but Lord, the privilege that you give us to be saved, an opportunity for people watching this, Lord, for all of us that is in humanity, an opportunity to turn from sin and grab a hold of your hand, because you did what normal men could not do. You lived a sinless life, and you gave your life for a people that didn't even want you back then, Lord. And we're so thankful that you first loved us, Lord, enough. And now we love you, Lord. And thank you for your sweet Holy Spirit and the chance to be saved. We pray for every person watching this, Lord. And we give you thanks for this. And bless our little group, Lord, as we do our best to lift you up. In Christ Jesus' name, amen. All right, let's start off.
Clap your hands, stomp your feet. The name of Jesus will not accept defeat. We're Christian warriors and we got a plan. Gonna follow Jesus, got my Bible in my hand. Come on, praise him. Come on, just praise him. Come on, praise him. Until the sun goes down. Said, get behind me, Satan, I'm walking on holy ground. But Lord Jesus, don't you understand? I'm gonna follow him to the promised land. Ain't got no time to be fooling around with you. Oh, Jesus said, I am the way and the truth. Come on, praise him, everybody now. Come on, just praise him. Come on, praise him until the sun goes down. I said, get behind me, Satan, I'm walking on holy ground. Sanctuary will not accept defeat. We're Christian cowboys, cowgirls, and we got a plan. We'll follow Jesus.
Come on, praise him.
Come on, just praise him. Come on, praise him. Till the sun goes down. I said, get behind. Satan, I'm walking on holy ground. I said, get behind. to Satan, I'm walking on holy ground.
So this next song we're going to play for you, this was written a long time ago, actually by Merle Haggard, and it has prophetic connotations to it even back then. I don't think it takes a Rhodes Scholar to look at the world and go, what is going on? Everything seems upside down. Everything seems like it's just in an awful shape. The abnormal has become the normal. As the Bible says and predicts in these days that we're living in, that people would begin to call evil good and good evil. Well, I tell you, this song kind of represents a little bit of that, but we have hope in Jesus Christ. Amen. We have hope in Him, and we're clinging to Him no matter what goes on in this world, and He's going to bring us through. So your faith and hope is in Christ Jesus alone. This is Jesus, Take a Hold.
Never been in the awful shape it's in. Jesus, take a hold and lead us through. Like the ancient Roman Empire, this world is doomed to fall. And it's much too big a thing for mortal men. Just take a look around and see. This world has never been in the awful shape it's in. And people scorn the things our leaders do. It's time a prayer was spoken from the heart of every man. Jesus, take a hold and lead us through.
That's what we're praying for. You ever felt like sometimes that there's just something in your life that you're standing before it and it's like some great mountain that can't be moved? That's when God works the best. Gail's going to sing this. Gail, do you have anything you want to say about this particular song?
Well, I just want to say, first of all, that I just love the Lord with all my heart. Yes. I'm so grateful for His presence in my life. He has never let me go. As I started to stray, the Holy Spirit calls us back.
Yes. Amen.
When we face mountains in our lives, we've got to go to Him. We've got to ask for the Holy Spirit to come and take control. This song has a special meaning to me, and I hope that it will to you as well.
Now, Bill wrote this next song, and it's about a heart of stone. And, you know, God has to take your heart. You have to be moldable in the hands of the Lord. Bill, tell us how you come to write this song, Bill.
Well, Jay, I was driving to Arizona, and I was on my way up to play with a group called Team Jesus, and we were doing the nationals for the Dove Awards. And I was praying as I, you know, I had plenty of windshield time. I was actually driving from California all the way to Arizona. And I was praying, seeking the Lord, and I asked him to show me, is there anything in my life that's separating me from him? And the Holy Spirit spoke to me, buddy, and let me tell you, the tears started rolling down my face as I was driving. Thought it was raining. And he said, you got a heart of stone. I said, what? Where did that come from?
Yeah.
So you got a heart of stone. I said, what do you mean I got a heart of stone? He said, well, you got unforgiveness in your heart.
Yeah.
And
gotta get rid of that.
You need to change that heart of stone, and I'll give you a heart of flesh. Amen. Well, by the time I got to Arizona, we actually played this song. Never rehearsed it or nothing. And it's this is called A Heart of Stone. And I hope you guys, if you got a heart of stone, then you need to seek the Lord in that and ask him to take that heart of stone away.
Amen.
And give you,
amen,
a heart of flesh just like he gave me.
Yes.
This old heart of stone got the man I want to be. I've been down the road called hell, is a life called misery. Heart of stone.
You will bow down to Jesus.
Heart of stone.
You will shatter into pieces.
Heart of stone.
I've got no room anymore.
This old heart of stone's
been shattered by the Lord.
Heart of stone.
You will bow down to Jesus.
Heart of stone.
You will shatter into pieces.
Heart of stone.
I've got no room anymore.
This old heart of stone's been shattered by the Lord. All Jesus is the one knows the road that you've been on. He's the only one that can throw away that stone. If you let him in, he can take away your pain. All unforgiveness will be gone in Jesus' name. Heart of stone.
You will bow down to Jesus.
Oh, heart of stone.
You will shatter into pieces.
Heart of stone.
I've got no room anymore.
This old heart of stone's
been shattered by the Lord.
Heart of stone. You will bow down to Jesus. Heart of stone. You will shatter into pieces. Heart of stone. I've got no room anymore. This old heart of stone's been shattered by the Lord. Heart of stone.
You will bow down to Jesus.
Oh, heart of stone.
You will shatter into pieces.
Heart of stone.
I've got no room anymore.
This old heart of stone.
Shattered by the Lord. This old heart of stone's been shattered by the Lord.
Heart of stone. old heart of stone. Heart of stone.
So this next song we're going to sing is, it's an old song. Randy Travis sang this song. It's Three Wooden Crosses. And have you been to the cross of Jesus Christ? That's where life-changing things happen in a person's life supernaturally. When we bow down before what Jesus has done in the presence of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, I hope that tonight you can reach out. There's opportunity. I don't know how much time this world has left to go. You can see what's going on in the world. We can see what's going on in Israel. We can see what's going on in our own communities. And folks, I think even a person who's not a biblical scholar can look and see that we can't go much further. So please take the opportunity. This song's all about opportunity. A preacher talking to somebody, just like I'm talking to you right now. And I'm giving you an opportunity in Jesus' name. All you got to do is call out to the Lord, and He'll do the rest. This is Three Wooden Crosses. A farmer and a teacher, a hooker and a preacher, riding on midnight bus bound for Mexico. One was headed for vacation, one for higher education, and two of them were searching for lost souls. Now that driver never ever saw a stop sign, and 18-wheelers can't stop on a dime. Now there are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. Now that farmer left the harvest, a home and 80 acres, the faith and love for growing things in his young son's heart. And that teacher left her wisdom in the minds of lots of children. She did her best to give them all her start. Now that preacher whispered, can't you see the promised land? As he laid his bloodstained Bible in that hooker's hand. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Why there's not four of them, heaven only knows. I guess it's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. Now that's the story that our preacher told last Sunday, as he held that blood-stained Bible up for all of us to see. He said, bless the farmer and the teacher and the preacher who gave his Bible to my mama, who read it to me. Now there are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. Now there's not four of them, now I guess we know. It's not what you take when you leave this world behind you. It's what you leave behind you when you go. There are three wooden crosses on the right side of the highway. All right. You know, there's somebody special in all of our lives. Somebody probably in your life that you can look at and remember. Maybe someone in your past, maybe somebody right now that's in your present. Someone that helped you find your way, not only in life, but to faith in God and in Jesus Christ. Gail, this song's special to Gail in that way. Why don't you tell everybody how this is special to you, Gail?
Well, this song is called Grandpa, and I'm sure you all know it. My great-grandpa was my grandpa, and he was a man of God. He lived on a farm in Menifee County. He never learned to drive. They drove mules to the store. He built his own house. We called him Pop. And my great-grandmother, we called her Mom. And they lived on that farm until they passed away. And he used to put me on his knee and tell me about those good old days. He used to tell me about the Bible and how he found Jesus. And I'm so grateful for a grandpa who would put me on his knee and tell me about Jesus.
Amen.
About the good old days, sometimes it feels like this world's gone crazy. Grandpa, take me back to yesterday, when the line between right and wrong didn't seem so hazy. Lovers really fall in love to stay, stand beside each other come what may. Was a promise really something people kept, not just something they would say and then forget? Families really bow their heads to pray, and daddies really never go. I just don't know. And Grandpa, let's wander back into the past and paint me a picture of long ago. Did lovers really fall in love to stay, stand beside each other a promise really something people kept, not just something they would say and then forget? Families really bow their heads to pray, and daddies really never go away. Whoa, Grandpa, tell me about the good old days.
Old days. This is another song that Bill wrote, Man in the Mirror. I've preached many a sermon on that. Who's looking back at you when you're looking into the mirror? The Bible says, let a man examine himself and see if he is of the faith. Every now and again, you got to take a look at what's going on inside and truly, truly be humble enough to admit what's going on in there and allow God to minister to you. Open up your heart wide open. I don't care what's going on in your life right now. Just allow God to minister to you in a very special way. Bill, talk to us about how you wrote this song, Man in the Mirror.
Well, you know, Jay, every song has a story. And this song, when you take a look at a guy like me, you know, I used to live in the biker world. And when you look at the outward man, sometimes we tend to judge.
Yeah.
And I think we're all guilty of it one time or another.
Yeah.
But you know, God don't look at the outward man.
No.
If you think that you got to clean yourself all up before you come to the throne of grace, before you come to the Lord, I've heard people say, well, just as soon as I get this done or I take care of this problem, then I'm gonna tell Jesus, you know. You know, forget all that. Jesus said, come as you are.
Yes.
Just like Amen. You are.
Amen.
When I got saved, I was a hooligan, man. I'm telling you, buddy. And when I looked in the mirror, I still seen the same old man, the same guy. But there'd been a change in my heart.
Yes.
God
Thank
changed
Jesus.
My heart.
Yes.
And that man in the mirror is no longer the same.
Amen.
And
Hallelujah.
I remember I wrote the chorus of that, the verses to that song, and I didn't have the chorus. And I was walking down the aisle in the grocery store, mind you, and this store was busy, and here I am, just an old biker looking kind of a dude. With my steel-toed boots on, still wearing
God
them.
Cleaned you up.
And I'm walking down the aisle, and I said, Lord, you know, when are you going to give me the chorus to this song? He said, and I'm walking a new walk. I'm talking a new talk.
Yes,
yeah.
Amen.
I'm singing a new song. I've been redeemed. Mm-hmm. And I started singing that, and I'm going down the aisles of the grocery store. And man, everybody was looking at me, and I was happy, happy, happy. So we're going to do this song, Man in the Mirror. There's a man in the mirror that keeps looking back at me. Reflections of a man that I used to be. You can see me on the This man in the mirror's been given a brand new name. I used to spend my hard money drinking whiskey, beer, and wine. All I ever cared about was having a party time. And one day it happened, Jesus got a hold on me. Well, this man I'm walking a new walk, I'm talking a new talk, I'm singing a new song, I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb,
by the blood of the Lamb.
Well, I'm a brand new man,
I'm a brand new man.
This man in the mirror's been given a brand new name. I'm a walking a new walk. I'm talking a new talk. I'm singing a new song. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb.
By the blood of the Lamb.
Well, I'm a brand new man.
I'm a brand new man.
This man in the mirror's
been given a brand new name.
And I'm a walking a new walk. I'm talking a new talk. I'm singing a new song. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb.
By the blood of the Lamb.
Well, I'm a brand new man.
I'm a brand new man.
This man
in the mirror's been given a brand new name.
Well, this man in the mirror's been given a brand new name. Take that, devil. Yeah.
Praise God. Praise God.
I'm glad I've been born again. How about you? And I'll tell you, the Bible says that when you get born again, all things become new. The outward man doesn't change, but this inward man completely dies and comes and is resurrected in the newness of Christ. You're given a brand new nature. You're given a brand new life in Jesus Christ. Your descendancy, which once at one time came from Adam and Eve, now when you get saved, comes directly from God in heaven, and you become a child of the living God with His nature about you, born again, blessed by God, filled with His Holy Spirit. Man, I'm telling you. Let me ask you a question. This song we're going to get ready to sing here is called This Is What Heaven Means to Me. This was written by Rusty Goodman in 1969. And I'll tell you, what does heaven mean to you? A lot of people look at this. I've heard people over the course of my ministry say, well, heaven's just going to be this boring place, right? Let me tell you something. To those that are fallen, if you love this world in its fallen nature right now, the Bible says it's not entered into the minds of men what good things God has prepared for them over there. And if this right here has such beauty as we see around us, what will the next world be? I can't wait to get there. I just know that heaven means to be saved, set free, living in the presence of God, where there is no evil, where there is no tears, where nobody's hurting, where you're with your loved ones, never to part again. Who wouldn't want to go to that wonderful, wonderful place? Amen. This is what heaven means to me.
Unending day where night will never be. A city where no storm clouds ever gather. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. What will it be when we get old? And join the throng upon the glassy sea. To join our loved ones and crown Christ forever. Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. And strife, we are free. No unkind words to wound the heart are spoken. This is just what heaven means to me. What will it be when we get over yonder and join the throng upon the glassy sea to join our loved ones and crown Christ forever? Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. Listen at this last part. And when at last we see the face of Jesus, before whose image other loves all flee, and when they crown him Lord of all, I'll be there. For this is just what heaven means to me. What will it be when we get over yonder and join the throng upon the glassy sea to join our loved ones and crown Christ forever? Oh, this is just what heaven means to me. Yes, this is just what heaven means to me.
Amen.
Yeah. One more, are we good?
Welcome back, and thank you all for singing for us, the Kentucky Wayfaring Strangers. I tell you what, that touched my heart. Mm-hmm. Every one of those songs, they are just very meaningful in everything that we need. And I'm going to tell you something there, Billy, when you're singing about the stony heart and then looking in the mirror, you sang just about me, brother, because I know exactly where you came from. And you know, God is willing to make us, we get a step forward and God will make the change. Yes. We don't have to make the change, but God will do that. Amen. And you know, he gives us so much. But if you want to get in contact with Pastor Jay Keaton, you can call him at 606-768-9959. And they're with Liberty and Faith on a podcast. And Pastor Jay, you want to come over and sit and maybe you can tell us a little bit here. We got a couple minutes. But tell us what's going on in your church or what's happening around the ministry that you have. And but you know, folks, we really want to send out our prayers for Don and for Dottie and, you know, for Sister Margaret as, we go through these trying times during the Christmas season. And I'm going to tell you something, what a great blessing it is to know that our Lord and Savior came because God the Father loved us. He says that he loved us so much that he gave his only begotten son so that we could have everlasting life. And, you know, everything is just wonderful if you put your trust and faith in God. Yeah. And, you know, that's where we're at today, you know, because like they said in the songs, you know, that this world's a terrible place. If you haven't looked around and seen what's going on, everything God made is beautiful. It's beautiful, but we have turned things upside down, like you said, where We think that evil is good and good is evil.
Yes.
You know, I'm telling you, we don't have a clue as to what's going on. So what's happening in the ministry where you're going?
Well, I'll tell you, we're not only do we have the Liberty and Faith podcast that I put out that people can, you can listen to that. I've got hundreds, it seems like, of sermons out there, but I attend the Index Community Church there in West Liberty, Kentucky. The senior pastor there is Mike Frisbee, wonderful man of God, truth preaching church.
Amen.
And I help
Amen.
Him out there. I preach there. Like I said, I attended. I pastored in Ohio for over 30 years. And I wanted to comment a little bit. You know, the world that we're in today, it's similar to that moment when Jesus looked at the disciples and all of the people that had been following Jesus for what he could do for them left. And he turned to the 12 and said, "Will you go too?" And we're at about a moment right now in this world with everything that's going on. It's one of those moments when the Lord is looking at us and saying, "Are you going to stay faithful? Are you going to go too?"
Yeah, right.
And so, you know, I just encourage you to stay faithful to Jesus Christ
to the end,
to the very end.
That's
it's
right.
It's the person that wins the race is the one that finishes it. And sometimes finishing is hard, but allow God to take the steps beneath you and he will deliver you home. And it's an urgent thing, I feel, in these days that we're living in. You know, it's things are just so terribly wicked in just a word.
Prophecy's being filled every day.
Absolutely,
yeah,
it is.
Every day. And
yes.
You know, as we look, we had that conversation, Brother Sammy and I, as we came up here, we had that conversation about, 2024 is getting ready to come about. But, you know, if the world continues on the same tumble as it's going,
yeah,
you know, we should start really looking forward to seeing Jesus come back.
Amen to that.
Because,
yes.
You know, this world needs him
right
now, today. And we're just, you know, we have to stay faithful and we have to stay true to that. And it's so good to hear that you're all having that ministry going on and
yes.
still reaching the lost souls. And
yes.
And we do need to stay faithful to the end.
Yes.
And, you know, God will supply all of our needs. And that's where we come in as Christians. We have to stand true.
Yes, absolutely.
We have to be the light unto the world.
Yes.
Because the
yes.
world is walking in darkness.
Yes.
And there's so much that is swaying people left and to the right.
That's
instead
right.
of having, where you're talking about that mountain, there seems like every place they go, there's
a mountain
in their way.
Yeah.
And God said to us as Christians, if you've got the faith of a mustard seed,
yes.
you can move that mountain
yes.
out of your way.
Yes.
And that mountain gets moved because Christ Jesus
yes.
will move it for
yeah.
you.
Yes.
You're not going to move it.
No.
But Christ Jesus
Absolutely.
Can move it.
Yeah.
God will move it. And the Holy
Amen.
Spirit will give
Amen.
Us strength to get through
yes.
it. And when we get through that side, there'll be another river to cross. There'll be something else that we got to do, but God will supply those needs.
You know, it's hard to tell somebody that's never experienced or tasted of the waters of God. It's very difficult to tell them exactly how you feel. You know, I was the guy in high school and growing up, you know, I ran the touchdown that won the game, or I hit the home run that did the same. But I tell you, the world has nothing to compare with what Christ does in your heart when you truly accept him as your personal
yes.
Lord and Savior.
It
is beyond measure and beyond my vocabulary to be able to describe his magnanimity within you. It is just the most amazing thing. And if you'll just humble your heart. And folks, it's time to let go. It's time to do it. It's time to ask Christ to be your Savior.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Brother it's time. Sam, we've got several prayer requests tonight, and I'll get you to go through some of them there and anoint them, and we'll pray over them before we close tonight.
Start us out. We have Hazel Dickey from Pulaski County, pledges $50 in honor of the singing group. Brenda from Morgan says prayer for family to get saved and attend church. That should be everybody's prayer for unsaved
Amen.
Loved ones. A prayer for Shirley Brandenburg, who has COVID and pneumonia. Hmm. Prayer for Frida, has COVID. Prayer for Wayne from Knox. A daughter, Becky from Pulaski, has stage 4 cancer.
Oh, praying.
Paul Long from Wolf, wife passed away. Prayer for Paul and family. We definitely need to do that. Grace Gunthrie from Lee County, health problems. Terry King from Menifee, 2 cancer patients. A friend that lost their grandson Also pray for Terry's family. Thelma from Madison, pray for grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and great-great-grandchildren.
Amen.
Our young people especially need the Lord to this time with all the problems we're facing. Jared from Garrett County has lung problems, diabetic, and just got out of the hospital. So we need to remember him that God continues to heal his body. Jerry from Clay City, hand problems. God knows the rest of these needs. We're going to go ahead and anoint them, as the Bible says. We're going to pray in faith, believing that it's going to shall be done.
Yes, absolutely.
Would you all pray with us? Our most kind and gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this music, Lord. We thank you for the sweet spirit we feel here. Lord, Father, you said that anything that has a name is subject to the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we speak to it all. Lord, we thank you in advance for the healings, Lord, the testimonies, Lord, for the sinner that's going to get saved. Lord, I thank you in advance for what's getting ready to happen, Lord. Lord, this world is in a much closer place, Lord, than it ever has been, Lord. Lord, I just ask that you send disciples out, Lord, to heal people, Lord, to help people get saved. Lord, Father, and we're going to thank you in advance, Lord, for the healings, Lord, for this revival sweeping this land. And we ask all these things in your name. Amen.
Amen. You know, there's so many needs out there that that we need to reach out and touch. And, you know, as we prepare to close tonight, we want to thank the Kentucky Wayfaring Strangers for singing for us tonight, to giving us the good message of the Lord and how you can be saved. And it's real simple. You just have to ask Jesus into your heart.
Yes.
And, you know, we've run out of time here tonight, and I know that, you know, we would love to be able to be on the rest of the night to be able to just to tell you all about Jesus and continue telling you until we could break through and Jesus could move upon you. But we know that we can't. And, you know, we just thank you for watching tonight. Continue to watch and to continue to lift up Don and Margaret in your prayers.
Yes.
And we want to thank you all for being with us. And you know, it's just so good that we could be in the presence of the Lord and be with each and every one. So our time is over, and we just want to thank you for being with us. Our prayer is that God would bless you, and for each and every one watching, have a good night, and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope that you are truly blessed and encouraged every time you watch. This program is made possible by your contribution and support. Would you become a financial partner of the Hour of Harvest with a one-time or monthly offering? You can send your pledges of support to the Hour of Harvest, Post Office Box Y, Bayville, Kentucky, 41311, or visit us online at www.hourofharvest.com. May God bless you.